各位佛友，大家晚上好。
Good evening, all Dharma friends.
我们现在准备讲今天晚上的课。
And we are going to begin with this evening's teaching now.
那么今天晚上的课，它的主要的内容是我们如何面对分路这样子一个题目。
So the focus of this evening's teaching is how to go about dealing with anger.
那么如何面对分路这个虽然这个是一个佛教的讲座但是呢我们有信仰的没有信仰的大家都可以用这个方法。
So even though this topic tonight it is a Buddhist teaching, nevertheless, regardless of whether you are religious or are not religious, the methods that we're going to be addressing tonight are ones that can be used by everyone.
因为我们每一个人的心里就有这个分路但是平时呢这个分路就是还没有发作的时候呢它在一个潜在这样子的状态。但是一旦遇到了外面的这个条件这样子的时候呢我们的分路立即就会产生。
Everyone in their mind experiences anger in a normal state before it has been activated or before it has arisen, it's existing in a latent state. And it's not until this latent potential of anger encounters particular external circumstances that it immediately then gives rise to anger.
然后这个分炉出来了以后呢我们很多人不知道怎么样去控制这个分炉。
But when it does arise, a lot of people are not sure how to go about controlling it.
控制或者是消灭烦恼分炉必须要有方法才能够解决。
In order to eliminate anger or to control it, it is necessary that we have methods to do this.
首先我们了解一下我们人为什么有愤怒，然后呢，愤怒它的本质是什么样子。
So the first thing that we need to do is go about getting an understanding of why we have anger, what it is, and what its essence is.
首先，那从佛教的角度讲，分路就是佛教讲的，分路就是佛教讲的善度善度之一。
So to begin with, from a Buddhist perspective, anger is classified as one of the three poisons.
那么分路为什么叫做毒为什么呢这个就是比如说我们的肉体吸了毒或者是中毒以后它会生病它会变得不健康。同时我们的精神有了这个分路的以后呢它也就变得不健康。
So why do we refer to anger as one of the poisons? Well, the reason is because just as our physical beings, if they ingest some kind of poison, become ill, so too do our minds, when they give rise to anger, become unwell.
然后我们的肉体中毒以后就需要治疗才能够康复。那么我们的精神又变得不健康的时候呢也需要有同样的治疗的方法有了这个治疗的方法才能够变得健康。
So just as when our physical bodies are ill, they require a treatment in order to regain their original state of health, so too do our minds when they become unhealthy. We need to treat them as well in order to recuperate our health.
那么这个治疗的方法，治疗的方法是什么样子呢？佛教就有很多的治疗的方法。那么其中我们今天给大家今天和明天两个这个讲座当中呢给大家介绍一些方法。
So as to various methods of treatment of anger, there are many in Buddhism. And over tonight's teaching and tomorrow night's teaching, I'm going to share with you two methods.
首先，好，我们刚刚提到了三毒，三度是哪个？第一个就是欲望过度的欲望贪婪，这是第一个。
So we just mentioned the three poisons. What are they? Well, the first of the three poisons is desire or greed.
然后第二个就是我们今天要讲的愤怒。
And the second of the three poisons is the one that we're going to be talking about tonight, and that's anger.
然后第三个呢，就叫做无明，用佛教的话讲无明，就是欲美物质。
And the third of the three poisons is what we refer to in Buddhist terminology as ignorance, a lack of understanding.
那么这个三毒佛教就讲贪嗔痴，这三毒它的根源就是无明，都是来自于愚昧物质。
So as for the root of the three poisons, greed, anger, and ignorance in Buddhism, we consider the root of these three to be ignorance.
因为我们的很多的愤怒，就是因为我们不了解这个世界的真相产生的。
A lot of the time, our anger is due to a lack of understanding of the true nature of the world.
然后我们的很多的欲望，也就是因为不了解这个世界的本质而产生的。
And in many cases, our desire is also as due to not having a proper understanding of the essence of the world.
如果我们彻底的了解了这个世界的本质，以及我们的生命的本质、自我的本质，这样子的话，那么就是不会有这样子的这个贪婪和愤怒。
If we did have a complete understanding of the essential nature of the world, the essential nature of our lives, of ourselves, then we would not give rise to greed and anger.
所以呢，这个三毒三毒，或者是所有的烦恼，它的根源就是愚昧物质。
So we can say that the root of the three poisons, or indeed all afflictions, is ignorance.
那么大乘佛教佛教虽然是一个非常非常庞大的这个理论非常庞大的佛经，但是这些所有的佛经，它们的内容，如果归纳这样子的话，才两个字，只有两个字。
Insofar as Mahayana Buddhism is concerned, it's a vast theoretical system. However, if we were to condense it into just two concepts.
那两个字是什么呢？第一个就是智慧。
These two concepts, the first of them would be wisdom.
第二就是慈悲心。
And the second, compassion.
那么整个的大乘佛教可以归纳为慈悲和智慧这两个当中。
So it's possible to condense all of the teachings of the Mahayana into these two concepts, wisdom and compassion.
那么学佛学佛是什么意思？学佛到底学什么呢？ 血脂灰和血慈悲心啊，这叫做学佛。
So when we talk about studying Buddhism or being a student of Buddhism, what is it that we mean by this? Well, primarily studying wisdom and studying compassion. This is what it means to study Buddhism.
然后修行啊，学佛修心，那修心修什么呢？也是两个，修慈悲心和修智慧。
And the same goes for practicing Buddhism too. What do we practice when we're a practitioner? Well, compassion and wisdom, these two things.
我们每一个人啊，都有智慧，都有慈悲心。但是呢，我们的目前我们的这个慈悲心和智慧呢，啊，这个非常有局限性。
All of us, every single one of us already possesses wisdom and we already possess compassion too. It's just that our current state of wisdom and compassion is very limited.
但是智慧的种子我们每一个人都有。
But everybody possesses in them the seed of wisdom.
然后慈悲心的种子我们的心里啊，先天就有。
And in our minds as well, we already possess the seed of compassion.
那么现在我们需要有一种方法，把我们的这个慈悲心要它培养，然后呢，我们的智慧也让它增长。
So what we are really in need of at this point in time is a method for us to nurture our compassion and a method for us to increase our wisdom.
比如说现在我们每一个人都有慈悲心，有爱啊，但是这个爱和慈悲心呢，啊，就是只有几个人，比如说父母、儿女啊、情人、朋友等等，这么几十个或者是几百个人。的这个范围，范围很小。
We can say that everyone at the moment has within them compassion, they have love within them. It's just that at this present point in time, most people's love and compassion is limited in scope. That is, it is only directed to a limited field of recipient. For example, one's parents or children, friends, perhaps several tens of people, maybe several hundreds, but in any case, limited in scope.
那现在我们啊需要用佛教的方法把我们的这个慈悲心的这个具先心啊这些结先啊全部打破，打破了以后呢，把我们的慈悲心啊可以扩展到所有生命所有人的身上。
So what we need at this point in time is a method from Buddhism that will allow us to take our current level of limited compassion and break through this and expand it so that it encompasses all living beings.
我们现在的这个慈悲心啊，就像在一个瓶子啊里装在瓶子里的一盏灯一样。在这个瓶子啊内部它是有光，但是这个光啊是没有办法照在外面。
At the present point in time, our compassion is like a candle inside a bottle. It is emitting a glow, but the glow is not enough to illuminate the wider room.
那这个时候我们啊需要什么？需要把我们的这个啊这盏灯。从这个瓶子啊拉出来，或者是把这个瓶子破碎啊，这样子以后呢，光啊可以照射啊周边的一切。
So what we need to do then is either take this candle or this lantern outside of the bottle, or smash the bottle that it is encased in, so that its light is able to fill the room.
啊，那么我们的慈悲心也是这样。虽然我们大家都有慈悲心，但是呢，有一个东西把我们的慈悲心啊，就是锁在我们的一个非常非常小的范围当中，啊，不让它啊走出去。
And it's the same with our compassion. At the present point in time, we all do have compassion in our minds, and yet there is something that is constraining it to a small scope, that is preventing it from expanding.
这个时候呢，我们把这个不让我们的慈悲心啊奏出去的这个东西，首先是什么啊？就把这个东西啊把它毁掉，毁掉了以后，消灭了以后呢，然后我们的慈悲心啊可以照亮啊所有的人。
The first thing we then need to do is to take that.Thing or that force that is preventing our compassion from getting out, as it were, so that our and to destroy it, to eliminate it, so that our compassion can radiate to all beings.
那么现在佛教认为啊，不让我们的爱，不让我们的慈悲心啊，奏出去的这个东西。实际上就是我们的愚昧啊，实际上就是我们的物质，所以我们用智慧，用智慧把这个无明啊，这个愚昧无智，把它端掉啊，把它啊这个啊毁掉。
So in Buddhism, we regard that which is preventing our love and compassion from expanding to be none other than ignorance. And so therefore what we need to do is use wisdom against that ignorance so that we can eliminate it.
我们人啊就我们人与人之间啊画了很多很多的界限，比如说不同的宗族，不同的人种，不同的信仰啊，不同的国度等等等等，分了很多很多，画了很多很多的界限啊，就是因为这些界限啊，把我们的这个慈悲心啊挡住、拦住，然后呢，不让它啊照亮啊所有的生命。
Generally, in terms of our interactions with other persons, we erect a lot of boundaries and borders, such as those related to race or ethnicity, religion or nationality. And it's precisely these boundaries or these borders that we put in place between ourselves and others that bounds or binds our compassion, that prevents it from expanding and radiating to other beings.
那么这么多的界限，画了这么多的界限，那么这些界限啊都是我们的愚昧和物质它画的。
In fact, all of these limits and boundaries that we put in place are done so by none other than our own ignorance.
如果我们把我们的愚昧啊这个物质啊端掉了以后呢，然后就这些界限啊，这些界限啊，全部啊都啊跨越，然后我们的慈悲心可以跨越所有的界限。
If we're able to eliminate our ignorance, then we will be able to transcend these boundaries and have our compassion transcend them encompass all.
那么愚昧和无知啊，要把它断掉，要把它毁掉。那么用什么样的东西来毁掉呢？那就是需要智慧。
So what is it then that we need to eliminate our ignorance? It is wisdom.
所以大乘佛教用智慧把这些所有的界限啊断掉啊，把这些所有的界限啊都把它跨越，然后呢，我们的慈悲心可以照亮所有的生命。
So in the Mahayana teachings, we take wisdom and we apply wisdom so that all of these boundaries and constraints can be eliminated and transcended, so that our compassion can illuminate all.
好，这个就是我们简单给大家介绍佛学佛的 这个方法啊，简单的就是两个字。
So, that is just a really simple introduction to the Mahayana approach to studying Buddhism.
好，接下来我们再进一步的讲这个如何面对愤怒的方法。
So from here on in, we are going to address tonight's topic, how to go about dealing with anger.
首先我们剖析这个愤怒它是一个什么样的东西，然后它以什么样的情况下产生。
So first we need to gain an understanding of what kind of thing anger is and under what kind of circumstances does it arise.
首先我们刚刚提到了佛教把这个愤怒叫做毒善妒之意，那它为什么是毒呢？
So we've just said thatanger is one of the three poisons. So why do we consider anger a poison?
就像毒就像毒会毁掉我们的健康一样，只要有这个愤怒那么它就会毁掉我们的很多很多的东西。
So just as poison is something that destroys our physical health, anger is something that destroys many positive things as well.
首先在我们的现实生活当中，比如说最简单的如果我们的心里有这个嗔恨心，我们对某一个人对某一个人或者是对这个社会不满这个产生了这样子的这个愤怒的时候呢，然后同时第一个毁掉的是什么呢？是我们自己的幸福感就是从此以后呢，我们的心里就没有这种开心这个幸福这种感觉。
So if we start to begin with just at the level of everyday life, a very simple level, we can say that when we give rise to anger in our mind, whether that be to another person or to society at large, the first thing that we destroy is our own happiness. Once we've given rise to anger, then that happiness we no longer locate.
这个愤怒一旦在我们的心里产生了以后呢然后呢从此以后我们所看到的所有的人或者是我们看到的所有的事情我们都看不惯，任何一个东西都让我们感觉到很不开心所看到的都是负面负面的都变得负面的。
Once we arouse anger in our mind, from this point onwards, wherever we go, whatever we look at, whoever we look at, we do not see in a positive light. It does not bring us happiness. We look upon everything with a very negative outlook.
然后我们这个从此以后呢，我们根本就感觉不到快乐开心高兴幸福。
And from this point onwards, do not experience happiness or pleasure.
然后第二我们的心里有了这样子的愤怒的时候呢，然后就是除了我们的生活，比如说白天我不让我们开心，而且晚上会失眠我们就是因为愤怒，然后呢想很多很多的事情，然后呢越想越不开心，那这样子最后就失眠。
And not only does giving rise to anger affect our happiness during the daytime hours, but also by giving rise to anger at night, we toss and turn and it over in our mind, and it causes us to lack sleep.
然后同时它会毁掉人与人之间的这种感情。
And then in addition, giving rise to anger is something that destroys the relationships or affection between people.
比如说啊，父母跟儿女啊，或者是朋友之间啊，如果平时啊对别人啊有付出啊，但是呢，如果经常啊对某一个人啊这个发出这个啊对某一个人生气愤怒，那这样子的话就会毁掉啊别人的感恩的心。
Whether it be between parents and children, or between friends, when we give rise to anger towards another, then we destroy the feelings of interpersonal gratitude.
比如说父母这个世界上对我们最有恩德恩重如山。但是呢，如果父母啊，就整天都是给我们发脾气、愤怒这样子的话，儿女也就逐渐啊，都就会这个有产生这个距离啊，逐渐的就会离开、远离。那么朋友就更不用说啊，所以这个一愤怒这东西一存在，这样子以后呢，我们身边的很多的好朋友就伤害到这个感情，然后他就把最好的离自己最亲的东西都会赶出去。
So even though parents, for example, the people who really we owe a tremendous amount to, a great debt of kindness, if they are constantly harboring anger towards their children, then this gradually leads to a distancing or estrangement between them. And we needn't mention then how it is for friends when there are feelings of anger between them. Anger ultimately leads us to lose those who are closest to us.
然后第四，如果有了这个愤怒我们它就会毁掉我们的这个心的平静和宁静因为有了愤怒以后呢，我们整天都去想很多的不开心的事情，所以我们的心没有办法平静下来所以就人感觉到很不开心，然后呢很累这样子，所以它就会扰乱我们的心的平静。
And then the fourth thing, or the fourth aspect that anger destroys, is our peacefulness of mind, or our equanimity. When we are angry about something and we think about it constantly all day, then this leads us to have a very unhappy or rather tired mind state. And so anger, it disturbs or it disrupts our peacefulness of mind.
然后第五从佛教的角度讲，比如说平时我们做很多的善事，做了很多，虽然做了很多的善事，但是呢，如果有这样子的很严重的这个愤怒，那么这个愤怒一产生的同时呢，我们在这个之前所做的很多很多的这些善都当下就会毁掉。
And then the fifth destructive aspect of anger is its destruction of our virtuous deeds. So we may have prior to a bout of anger done a great deal of good, of virtuous things. However, the very moment that we give rise to anger, we destroy the virtue of these previously positive acts.
然后第六更严重的，更加的严重的，就是这个愤怒不仅仅是毁掉自己的很多很多毁掉自己的幸福感、自己的睡眠、自己的朋友之间的感情等等，除了这些以外愤怒就会毁掉他人，就毁掉别人。
And then the sixth destructive aspect of anger is actually the even more serious. So anger just doesn't just destroy our own happiness or our own quality of sleep or our relationships and affectionate relations with others. Anger has the capacity to actually destroy others.
比如说 因为有些人啊，因为各种各样的原因，自己不高兴、不开心的时候，然后没有控制住自己的愤怒啊，然后呢，就会毁掉了很多无辜的人。
Some people, because they are angry and they're not able to control it properly, they will destroy or be destructive towards many faultless people.
比如说啊，很多的学校也就啊发生了这个枪杀案。
For example, there has been many shooting incidents in schools.
然后很多的公共场合啊，也有啊，也有发生类似的这个枪杀，在这个很多集市啊，四五十个这个无辜的人啊，就是在这个死在这个枪口下啊，有这样子的事情经常发生。
And shooting incidents of a similar nature that take place in public spaces occur and result in a great many faultless or innocent people dying.
然后我们在这个社会上啊，就遇到了一些不太公平的啊这个待遇，这样子的时候呢，然后又把自己的这个情绪没有控制好，这样子以后呢，然后又产生了一系列的后续的很多很多啊不开心的事情。
Or in social life, when we encounter things that are a bit unfair or unjust, we don't control our emotions as we should, and therefore give rise to a whole series of negative consequences.
好，这样子我们啊，从六个方面啊看啊，这个愤怒啊就会毁掉啊我们的很多东西，所以呢，它就叫做妒。
So we've counted just now seven different destructive aspects of anger, and it's because of anger possessing these destructive aspects that we consider it a poison.
简单的说啊，愤怒就会毁掉我自己，然后呢也毁掉他人啊，所以就是这，因为这两个啊，所以它就是妒。
So putting it in its most simple terms, we can say that anger is something that is destructive of ourselves. It's also something that's destructive of others, and that's why we consider it a poison.
好，这个就是愤怒它的作用。
So that is the effect or the function of anger.
然后接下来啊，我们再了解一下，那么愤怒啊，它怎么样产生的？
So let's consider now how anger actually arises.
有九个原因。
There are nine reasons why anger arises.
那么这九个原因呢，就是说，比啊。对某一个人啊，我对某一个人产生这种愤怒的时候呢，我为什么对他啊有这个愤怒呢？我认为啊，他过去啊伤害过我，现在啊或者是现在啊伤害我，或者是未来啊会伤害我，所以我对他产生啊这样子的愤怒啊。对于我自己的不离啊，过去、现在、未来。
So the first three of these are nine reasons pertain to harm that we perceive done to ourselves by another person, and that can be harm that was done in the past, harm that's being done now in the present, or harm that we believe will take place in the future.
啊，另外的三个呢，就是啊。我对某一个人啊，这个生气的时候呢，我认为他啊，对我的家人、对我的朋友啊，过去啊，对他们有伤害，现在啊，对他们有伤害，未来将会啊，对他们有伤害啊，会害他们啊，所以就是因这样子的想法啊，这样子的想法就产生啊，这个。愤怒。
And the next set of three reasons that lead us to give rise to anger relate to when we perceive anger being done to someone who is close to us, whether it be a family member or friends. And again, this can be anger that we perceive being done right now in the present, or having been done in the past, or potentially occurring in the future.
然后最后的三个啊，最后三个是我们认为啊，某一个人啊对我的啊对我不好的人啊，比如说对我的仇人啊，过去啊对他好啊，现在啊对他好，或者是未来会对他好，所以啊我就不高兴，我就对这个人有看法啊。所以就对他啊产生了这个愤怒。
And then the final set of three reasons that leads us to give rise to anger relates to when we perceive someone to be doing beneficial to someone we don't like, so to be treating an enemy well. And again, this can be a perception of treating someone we don't like well in the past, in the present, or the future. And it's on account of this that we give rise to strong opinions which lead to anger.
比如说啊，我们所有人都是这样子。比如说，我跟另外一个人啊产生了矛盾啊这样子的时候，然后呢，谁啊对啊这个人好啊，那么我就会不开心啊；谁对这个人不好啊，那么我就会开心啊。就是这样，这个我们啊普通的人都是这样子的。
So most ordinary people are exactly the same in this regard. Let's just say we give rise to or we experience conflict with another person, then we generally find ourselves feeling happy when others are bad to them and feeling unhappy when others are good to them or treat them well. So this is in general how ordinary people think.
那么这个九个啊，这个原因啊，虽然讲了九个，但是呢，在这个当中呢，我们深入的去了解的时候呢，其实就是一个原因，就一个原因让我们产生了愤怒。
So even though we've just said there were nine different reasons or nine different situations that lead us to give rise to anger, if we're able to look at these a little bit more closely, we'll find that in actual fact, there's really only one reason that causes our anger.
那么其中一个是什么呢？就是我啊，我这个概念啊，有了这个我的概念以后，就会有他啊，自和他啊，然后呢，我们把自和他的这个界限分得非常的清楚，这样子以后呢，然后就产生了很多很多的烦恼。
If we look at these nine reasons, we will find that the constant or common factor is this concept of self. And once we have a self concept, then we automatically have the concept of other. And it's when this boundary between self and other, we erect it in a very clear way that it causes anger and all manner of afflictive emotions to arise.
那么这个时候我们把我啊的地位在我们的心里把我的地位啊放在很高啊放得非常非常的高。然后呢除了我以外的其他人的啊其他的生命他们的地位在我们的心里放得很低啊啊这样子以后呢这个我和他啊的地位有很大的一个相差差距那这样子的时候啊然后就产生很多很多的愤怒很多很多的不满。
And this occurs when our self-concept, our sense of ourselves, we place in a very high position. And by contrast, position others in a very low position. And when there is this great gap between where we locate ourselves and then when we locate others, this gives rise to a great deal of potential anger.
如果我们有一种方法啊，有一种方法把我和他啊，自和他的这个界限啊，稍微比较模糊一点啊，或者是说我和他的这个地位啊，稍微啊平衡啊平衡一下啊，这样子的话，我们的很多烦恼就会消失啊，就会减少。
If we had a method that enabled us to take that boundary between self and other and make it a bit more blurred or blurry, or rather to have a method that enabled us to level our sense of ourselves and others, then this would enable us to reduce or eliminate a great deal of our affliction.
我们大家啊，可以想一想，如果我的啊，这个内心当中，把这种我的概念啊，把这种我的概念断掉啊，或者是把它扔出去啊，如果是这样子的话，那会是什么样子？会发生什么样的事情啊？大家应该去想一想。
Everyone, just take a moment to think what would happen if we took this concept of self inside our minds and eliminated it, got rid of it. Then what would happen? What does everyone think would happen?
我们很多人觉得啊，这怎么可能呢？啊，因为我一个人在这个地方啊，我怎么可以把我的这种我的概念啊，怎么能够把它扔掉呢？怎么能够把它断掉呢？怎么可能呢？这就是不符合现实，因为我一个生命的个体，实实在在就在这里啊，那怎么可以我把我的心理啊，把这个我的概念怎么样可以扔掉呢？这怎么可能呢？我想很多人会有这样子的疑问。
You know, a lot of people would respond to this by saying, well, it's just not possible. How can you do that? I am here. This individual called me is really substantially here. How is it possible that I could eliminate or get rid of my sense of self? It's completely unrealistic. I imagine a great many people would think in this way.
其实啊，这个是有方法的。有一种方法就完全可以把这个界限可以把它抹掉。
But in actual fact, there is a method. There is a method that is completely able to erase that boundary between self and other.
也就是说，完全可以把自和他的这个界限啊，可以把它抹掉。
So this method is completely equipped.To remove this separation or boundary between self and other.
比如说我们啊，有几百个人啊，在这里的时候啊，我们可能每个人都有不同的啊，这个我的概念啊，每一个人都有不同的我的概念。比如说我们比如说啊，可以这么讲，简单说啊。比如说我们都是啊，在来自于不同的地方啊，来自于不同的地方。那么比如说我们这里啊，我们这里几百个人当中呢，有十个啊不同的这个群体。那么十个，假设有十个不同的群体，那么每一个群体是来自于不同的地方啊，这样子的时候呢，我们人会觉得啊，我们是个，比如说我是属于第一个啊，这个人群，这样子的话，我对这个人群当中的人都有一种啊，就是有一种我的啊这种观念。比如说我们啊，比如说第一组啊，我们把人分成十组啊。第一组，如果我属于第一组，我们是第一组，大家都是一个地方的人，那这样子的话，这个第一组当中，比如说有五十个人的话，那么这个时候呢，我对这个五十个人啊，就会有一种感情啊，就会像啊，我们都是一个地方的人 啊，这个时候呢，我会对五十个人会说我们啊，用这两个字来形容啊，我们啊，然后其余的九个组啊，第二组、第三组啊，对他们我不会说我们啊，我就会对这个第一组里面的人会说我们。
So if, let's just say among us here, we have a couple hundred people, let's say we have 10 different groups that are made up of people who come from different places. So let's just take the first group, say it's got 50 people in it, then what would take place is that we would feel a sense of attachment. We would associate a sense of self to this group that we belong to of people who come from the same place. And we would refer to everyone in this group with the pronoun, we would use the word us, we, and then we would, in reference to people from the other nine groups, we would describe them as them or they.
所以这个时候我对啊这个第一组啊里面的五十个人，我就啊希望他们好啊，希望他们不要有痛苦，希望他们不要遇到任何的这个困难啊，希望他们好好的，那么这样子。然后除了这个第一组的人以外，其他人啊不怎么在乎，不怎么关注，不怎么关心啊，这时候是这样子。
And at this point, we would feel that we wished very much that everyone else in our group of 50 had experienced good fortune, didn't encounter suffering or hardship. But in respect of everyone else in the other nine groups, we wouldn't care particularly about them. We would feel rather indifferent.
如果有一天我们十个我们十个这个十族人所有的人如果我们到另外一个地方这样子的时候呢，这个时候我们这个十个族的人的这个十族的内部的这个界限这个时候会模糊的到了另外一个地方的时候呢，我们会觉得我们大家都是一起来的，这个时候呢，我对十族的人对十个这个族群的人都有一种我们这样子的概念。那这个时候呢，我就比如说我们到了另外一个地方，另外一个地方的人，我觉得他就是用他们这个字来描述他们。然后这个时候呢，我们这边的人原来是只有五十个人，我认为是我们。那现在呢，几百个人我都认为是我们。
However, if one day everyone from our 10 different groups were to relocate to another place entirely, then at this point we would cease being 10 separate groups and we would start to refer to the boundaries between our 10 different groups would become more blurry, they would disappear, and instead we would start to consider ourselves one group and would start to attach that sense of us or we to our group and would then begin to look upon the people in the new place that we had relocated to as the others.
那么这个问题佛教很早就有讲，那么科学家脑神经科学家发现了一个问题。
So as for this issue, Buddhism addressed it long ago. It's one that neuroscience has also addressed too.
比如说用针来扎扎我的身体扎我自己的这个身体的时候呢，我的这个大脑的某一个部分就会发出这个脑电波。
Neuroscience has discovered is that when I take a pin and prick myself with it, then a particular part of my brain will give rise to electromagnetic waves.
然后我看到我的朋友扎针的时候，我看到我的朋友被扎针的时候，然后我的同一个地方的这个脑电波 啊，跟我自己扎针的时候是一样的，就发出这个脑电波。
Similarly, if I were to see a friend being pricked by a pin, then the exact same part of my brain would also give rise to the same kind of activity as if it were me being pricked myself.
那么这个时候，如果换一个另外一个人啊，不是我的朋友，我一个陌生人啊，扎针，我看到他扎针了啊，但是呢，我的啊，这个脑电波就不一样，我没有刚才这种脑电波。
However, if we were to take a different person, a stranger, someone I didn't know, and they were to be pricked with a pin and I were to see it, then my brain would not respond in the same way at all.
那么为什么呢？这就是一种我们的意识的意识它的一个作用。比如说我有十个朋友，那么这样子把我的意识把这十个人当作是我们我们然后除了这个十个人以外叫做他们所以我们扎针的时候我有这个脑电波，他们扎针的时候我没有这样子的脑电波。
And the reason for this is it's an effect of the mind, it's a reaction of the mind. Essentially, the 10 people that I regard as friends, I consider them us. Everyone else I see as others. And so when me or the other 9 or 10 people in my close group experience being pricked, then I give rise to a certain kind of brain response, but not in the case of people from other groups.
这就是说我们的这个这个群体里面的人被扎针的时候我会担心会担心他们疼，然后就有这种颠簸。然后除了这个我们的这个群体里面的另外的人扎针的时候呢，然后我不怎么关心他，所以呢我这个脑颠簸就不一样。
And the reason is because when it's someone from my own in-group, then I'm concerned for them experiencing pain. And so when I see them being pricked, then I give rise to a brain response, but not in the case of people from the out-group for whom I don't feel much at all.
如果有一天我们地球上的70亿人口都到火星上然后呢假设在火星上我们遇到了其他的生命，这样子的话，那么这个时候呢我们对地球上的70亿人口，我一定会觉得都是我们。
If one day all of us 7 billion people on the Earth were to go to Mars and we were to encounter another life form, then all of a sudden all of us Earthlings would be one group.
那这个时候地球上70亿人口当中任何一个人被扎针那么我就会发出这种跟我自己一样的这个脑电波。
And at that point, if any one member of the 7 billion Earthlings were to be pricked, then my brain would give rise to a particular response.
那么这个就是说我们对这些人这个生命当中有小部分的人一个非常非常小的范围的人平时我就觉得我们我的亲戚，我的朋友然后这样子，比如说一个宗族的人，一个信仰的人，这样子就是一个很小很小的范围当中就把这个界限分得很清楚。那么除了这个小范围的人以外，其他的人然后我们的这个爱我们的慈悲心就没有办法跨越那么就是有一个这样子的东西把它锁定了。
So this is how it usually is in our everyday life. The scope of persons to whom we in our in-group is very small, just contained to our friends, our family, or people from the same race or a same religion. And so it's because of these boundaries that constrain us, that prevent our love and our compassion from transcending them and encompassing all beings.
那么我们把人啊或者生命啊分成这样子的小范围的生命啊分成很多很多小范围啊分了很多很多的花了很多很多的界限这样子以后呢然后我们的爱我们的慈悲心的范围也就越来越小。
So when we divide people or beings into lots of little groups or subcategories, then this has the effect of decreasing or reducing the scope of our compassion.
那么这个范围越小，我们就越容易产生愤怒，因为除了这个小范围的人以外，对其他人啊，我们非常非常容易产生烦恼啊。产生愤怒。
And the smaller this scope of persons is, the more likely we are to feel anger. The scope of persons to whom we are likely to give rise to anger, in fact, is therefore correspondingly enlarged.
所以佛教啊教我们把这个范围啊。越来越扩大，越来越扩大，最后把所有的人，所有的生命，都纳入这个范围。
So what Buddhism teaches us to do, or instructs us to do, is to continually enlarge this scope of beings who are the object of our love and our compassion, so that ultimately our scope includes all beings.
那么所有的人，人类，所有的生命，就纳入这个范围以后呢，然后我们的这种愤怒啊，就会越来越减少。
Once we are able to bring all beings and all persons within this scope of our compassion, then we will find that our anger increasingly reduces.
那么这个有没有可能呢？比如说，我们把全世界的人70亿人口，或者是所有的生命啊，都纳入这个范围，有这个可能吗？这个能吗？啊，完全是可以的。
So you might ask whether this is actually possible. Is it whether it's possible for us to bring all 7 billion people or all life forms on the earth within this scope of objects of our compassion? And the answer to that is yes, it's completely possible.
大家必须要明白。我们的意识啊，我们的人的意识是可以被训练啊，可以被训练的。
What everybody needs to understand is that our minds can be trained. They are very trainable.
如果我们平时啊，我们的这个慈悲或者爱的范围当中，只有几个人啊，那么这样子的话。我们的这个范围会越来越小，越来越小。
If the number of people or beings within our present scope of love and compassion is very small, then it will just continue to get smaller.
最后啊，除了自己以外啊，谁都不爱啊，对谁都啊没有慈悲心。除了最后就是自己一个啊，只剩下自己一个。
Until one ultimately reaches a point where there is nobody in that scope except for oneself.
如果我们啊平时有佛教有慈悲心的修法，有爱的修法啊，我们大家都知道，慈悲是非常有价值，爱啊是非常有价值，但是我们不太清楚啊，我们怎么样对所有人啊有慈悲有爱，这个方法是什么？ 我们大家都不是很清楚。
So all of us know that cultivating love and cultivating compassion is extremely valuable. It's extremely precious. And yet not everybody knows the appropriate method for cultivating love and compassion so that it encompasses all beings.
好，这样子以后呢，我们现在啊发现啊，这个我们为什么分路啊？分路的原因是什么呢？我们把人，我们把生命啊分成啊很多的这个不同的群体，画了很多的界限啊。原因其中一个原因就是这个，这是第一个。
So what we've now seen so far is that one of the main reasons why we give rise to anger is our habit of dividing people into various groups, placing boundaries between different kinds of people.
那么这个训练的方法呢，大家啊，如果有兴趣的话，我们可以进一步的去了解佛教的这个慈悲心的训练的方法。
And in respect of the method of training our minds that we can use in respect of this, if everyone is interested, then they can further learn about the methods of cultivating compassion in Buddhism.
好，这是我们讲了为什么分炉这个原因。那么接下来当我们有了这样子的分炉的时候，我们怎么样去控制，这个控制的方法呢？简单介绍一下。
So what we've spoken about thus far is the reason, or one reason for why we give rise to anger. And now I'd like to go on and talk a bit about what we can do when we actually give rise to anger, what we can do to control it.
那我们平时在工作生活当中平时都有很多很多发脾气生气愤怒这样子的时候。
So, in the everyday course of our lives at work or wherever else, it's very common for us to experience many moments when we feel angry or irritated or have bad moods.
那我们大家都不愿意自己让自己生气，我们没有一个人愿意或者喜欢生气，但是呢，我们遇到一些问题的时候呢，就是没有办法控制自己的情绪。
So it's for most people, it's not that they wish to give rise to anger, that they want to, that they like to do this. It's that when they encounter particular conditions, they are unable to control their emotions.
其中有几个具体的方法。那么这个具体的方法呢，我们平时要做一点，稍微做一点训练然后呢，训练好了以后呢，到时候随时都可以用。
So there's a few concrete approaches we can use in these sorts of situations that we need to train ourselves in a bit first. And once we've established a bit of a certain level of training, then we'll be able to deploy them whenever we need to in our lives.
这个理论理论是非常简单的，但是这个理论我们知道了以后，如果没有去训练的话，那到时候需要用的时候用不上。
So these methods or these approaches are very simple to understand in theory. However, if we do not actually train ourselves in using them, then when we actually do need to, we'll find ourselves that they'll be completely useless.
比如说我今天就是坐在这里给大家讲这个如何去控制愤怒的这种方法。但是如果我自己没有训练的话那么我也只是懂理论，但是我也会生气那么你们也都是一样这个理论是非常简单，但是如果知道了这个理论以后，如果我们没有去做没有去训练，那这样子呢，到时候大家都用不上。
So it's the same with me. I'm sitting here today talking to you about what we can do to control anger. However, if myself, I don't train actually in implementing these methods or approaches, I just understand the theory and talk about the theory, then I'll find myself being useless when actually confronted with anger. And it's the same for all of you here. We need to go beyond simply the theory of understanding how this works and actually training ourselves in it so that we can implement it in practice.
好，首先啊，第一个方法，第一个方法呢，比如说某一个人啊对我不好，然后呢我对他不满，我对他啊这个愤怒，那这样子的时候，或者是某一个人啊他对我不满啊，他对我产生了这个愤怒啊啊，当我们遇到这样子的时候呢。然后我们怎么办?
So the first method relates to a situation where someone, say, treats us bad, makes us feel unpleased, and then makes us feel angry, or a situation where someone else is unhappy with us, is angry with us. So this method relates to this kind of situation.
当我们遇到这样子的问题的时候呢，当下啊，当下。我们大家都 不太好控制自己的情绪，也许会发作啊，也许会很激动啊。但是呢，这个激动过了以后，然后呢，我们可以去思考啊这个问题，然后通过这种方法把我们的这种愤怒把它化解啊，这个完全是可以的。
So this particular method, it might very well be that in the heat of the moment, the very moment that this is happening, that we're not able to control our emotional response and find ourselves becoming agitated or excited. However, if we are then able to think and reflect a little bit, then this will be effective in enabling us to dissipate our anger.
比如说我们啊，就是有人啊，就对我们不满啊，或者是我就做了一件我特别不开心，不开心的这样子的事情啊，这样子的时候呢，啊，我一开始的时候就不生气啊，如如不动啊，这种就不太好啊，不太好做啊，不容易啊，这个就是如果没有一定的训练，这个不容易的。
So let's just say that someone is unhappy with us, they're angry with us, or they've done something that we really don't like. Then in the very beginning, it's very difficult for us to respond with a complete stillness or equanimity. It's without prior training, it's very difficult for us to respond in this way.
但是我们很多时候，比如说，啊今天某一个人啊，就是做了一件让我特别啊愤怒的事情，啊，说了让我特别愤怒的话，这样子以后呢，我们平时啊，不仅仅是当下很激动，而且啊，两天三天啊都有这个啊平静啊没办法平静啊，两三天都不开心，两三天都啊。心里很难受，有这种情况。
So let's just say that we've got a situation where someone's done something to make us feel unhappy. We feel worked up. It lasts for 2 or 3 days. And during this time, we're not able to enjoy peacefulness of mind. We feel upset for this entire time.
那这个问题啊，我们稍微啊注意一下就可以解决的。
So this kind of problem, if we pay a bit of attention, then we will be able to resolve it.
好，那么这个有很多种方法，那么其中我们先啊给大家介绍一个方法。
So there are many different approaches that we can take, but tonight I'd just like to emphasize one.
一个方法，第一个就是理解啊，理解对方。
And this method is understanding our other.
比如说啊，有人说我特别不开心的话啊，或者是有人做我 特别不开心的这个事情啊，这样子的时候呢，首先啊要理解。
So what this means is if someone says something to us that we really don't like, or they do something to us that we really don't like, the first thing that we need to do is gain an understanding of them in doing these things.
那我们很多人觉得为什么要理解呢？啊，他就是做了这么啊不应该做的事情，然后呢说了这么不应该说的话，我为什么要理解呢？啊，很多人的第一个反应啊就是这样子的。
Many people's first response would be or is, why should I go about understanding or empathizing with this person? They've done something wrong or they've said something wrong. Why should I empathize or try to understand their subjectivity?
那么这个时候的有一个方法是什么？啊，他为什么要说这样子的话？啊，他为什么说让我特别不开心的话？啊，然后呢，他为什么要做让我特别不开心的这样子的事情？原因是什么？这个里面呢，我们做任何事情都有很多很多的客观的因素啊，这个我们这个时候呢要静下来去思考一下。
So at this point, we can quietly reflect on the reasons why the person in question has said these things or has done these actions. What are the reasons? In every single situation, there are going to be many different objective factors. And so these are things that we can reflect upon.
那么我们的啊，绝大多数的人的这种这个时候的这种做法是什么呢？我们认为就是他不对啊，他不应该这么说，他不应该这么做，这样子一开始的时候就谴责啊，指责别人啊，那么就不思考自己有没有问题。我们的一贯的做法就是这样子。
So for most people, our habitual response in this kind of when this sort of situation arises is to think, well, that person shouldn't have done this. They shouldn't have spoken in this way. They shouldn't have acted in this way. Our habitual first response is to blame or to censure the other person.
那么这个时候啊，我们激动了，激动过了以后，两分钟、三分钟、五分钟过了以后，然后静下来再去思考一下。他这么做啊，他为什么说这样子的话？他为什么这么做？跟我有没有关系啊？这要思考一下。
But when the firstfew minutes of agitation or excitement has passed, then we should reflect quietly ourselves as on the reasons for why the person has acted as they have, and ask ourselves whether or not it had anything to do with our own selves.
任何一个事情的发生啊，有很多的客观的因素。
Whenever anything happens, there are always many objective causes.
那么他说这样子的话，做这样子的事情，也有很多。也肯定会有很多客观的因素。
So this person in speaking as they did or in acting as they did also no doubt was operating under many objective conditions.
那么这些客观的因素当中有没有我的一些原因？
And amongst these various objective causes or factors, are there any that relate to me?
如果发现啊，他为什么这么做啊，跟我有关系啊，跟我自己有关系，那么这样子的话呢，那我们是理解他啊，理解对方是理所当然的事情，我们应该理解别人。
And if upon so reflecting, we discover that actually there are factors to do with ourselves, that.Play into the actions or words of the other person, then empathizing with them or understanding them is something that we should, of a matter of course, do. If there's our own culpability inside, then naturally we should understand them.
这是第一。然后第二，也许啊，跟我没有任何的关系， 啊，也许跟我没有任何关系。
So that's the first situation. The second is reflecting on the other person's actions and words, if we may discover possibly that there are no factors or are no conditions that are related to ourselves.
那么就是说我没有做任何啊让他说这样子的话或者做这样子的事情的啊没有我没有做过任何这样子的事情。
That is to say, we might conclude that we didn't do anything to prompt them to speak in that way, or we didn't do anything to prompt them to act in that way towards us.
那么对方啊，他认为有啊，他认为我做了一些对他不利的事情啊，那么其实我没有。那这样子的话，对方是错了，是他错了啊，因为他不知道他错了，所以他就。说我不开心的事啊，那么正因为他错了啊，所以我也可以理解。
However, in this situation, if we conclude that there wasn't anything that we did to cause them to act in this way, then the other person, our interlocutor, in thinking that.We did were at fault. That is, they were at fault. They didn't realize, and so therefore, our understanding or our empathy towards them derives from or is grounded in an understanding of their faulty perception.
那么这样子，我们静下来思考的时候呢，啊，比如说，啊。他说让我不开心的话啊，那么这个当中呢，只有两种可能，除了两种可能以外，没有第三个啊。也许有我的原因啊，也许没有我的原因，除了这两个以外，不会有第三。
Whenever anything happens, when someone says something something upsetting, or they do something upsetting, there are only two possibilities. The first is that we did something to contribute to it, or we didn't do anything to contribute to it. There's really no other possibility aside from these two.
那么这两个当中，如果有我的原因啊，那就当然就可以理解了啊，我应该理解。
If I did something to contribute to the situation, then of course understanding and forgiving the other person is something that I should do.
如果没有我的原因啊，没有我的原因，那就是他错了啊。那么他错了，他不是故意的，他是他错了啊，所以我也可以理解啊。难道我永远都不会犯错吗？我们大家都会犯错，所以啊，也可以理解。
But similarly, if we discover that we didn't do anything to contribute to the situation, then it's a case of the other person being at fault. That is, that they are not being angry on purpose. It's due to them having to being at fault, being mistaken. But in this case, we can equally be understanding and empathetic and forgiving of them if we take into account the fact that, of course, weoften find our own selves at fault in many situations. So in either situation, we find ourselves being able to extend understanding to the other person.
那么我们的很多的愤怒，很多的当下的这种激动，啊，这种激动，绝大多数都是盲目的，我们根本就没有来得及去警醒，啊，这个观察，思考，盲目的激动。
In the vast majority of our cases, our anger is something that's given rise to in the heat of the moment. That is, it's a blind kind of anger. It's not an emotional response that we have been able to consider or rationalize or think about or analyze.
好，另外一个简单的方法，啊，这是第一个方。第二个方法呢，我们比如说，啊，某一个人，啊，收离啊，哪一个母棍啊，打我们啊，打我们的时候，这个时候直接让我感觉到啊疼痛，感觉到痛苦的啊是谁啊？就是他人的啊这个石头 和木棍啊，或者是这个人的手啊，才是让我直接感觉到痛苦的。
Or another approach that we can take, it's a simple one, and in this case we can think, let's just imagine someone is beating us with a stick or beating us with their hand or with a stone, then in this case we should ask, well, what is it that is most directly causing us pain? And we discover that most directly it is the stick or the hand or the stone.
可是我们啊，对木棍和对这个人的手不会产生啊愤怒，我们对这个人啊产生愤怒。
But we never find ourselves getting angry with the stick or getting angry with the hand. We always give rise to anger towards the person.
那么我们为什么对石头、对木棍、对这个东西啊？不产生愤怒，而对这个人啊产生愤怒呢
？So why is it that we never or we always feel angry towards the person, but never feel angry towards the stone or the stick or the hand？
我们认为啊，这人的手或者是手里的东西啊，它不是主动，它是被动的啊。主要的原因就是因为这个人啊，所以我们对人啊产生愤怒啊，对受力的东西不产生愤怒。
And the reason for this is that we regard the implement in the hand as being passively controlled, that the active party or the agency is being exercised by the person. So that's why we tend to feel anger towards the person, but not anger towards the weapon or the object that is causing us most directly pain.
如果这个道理是对的，那我们对谁啊愤怒，对谁不愤怒啊，就是以谁是主动的，谁是被动的啊，这样子分别，那这样子的话，那么我们最后也不应该对这个人啊产生愤怒。为什么呢？因为人也是被动的。人也是被动的，他不是主动的啊，他不是自愿的，他也不想生气。他也不想做这样子的事情啊。那么谁是主动呢？主要就是他的烦恼，他的愤怒啊。因为人的心里有愤怒，所以他控制不住他的嘴巴啊，乱说话，然后控制不住他的这个身体啊，说一句打人啊，这样子。所以呢，最后啊，人也是被动的，真正的啊。我们的真正的仇人、敌人，不是这个人，而是他的烦恼，他的这个愤怒。
So if this logic is valid, that is that we are legitimately angry, we should feel legitimate anger, or we can feel legitimate anger to active.People who actively harm us, but we shouldn't feel anger towards those who passively or non-actively harm us, then in either case, we shouldn't feel angry towards the person. And the reason for this is that people who harm us or make us angry are, in fact,passive themselves. They are in actual fact not in full agency. They are controlled by their own afflictions, their own anger, and it's due to their control by these things, their passiveness in respect of these forces, that they say all kinds of things and do all kinds of things. So in actual fact, the real enemy isn't the person, but the afflictions or the anger that controls them.
所以我们对某一个人啊产生矛盾的时候，然后我们的真正的我们的仇人啊，我们的敌人，不是这个人啊，而是这个人的心中的愤怒啊，才是最终极的啊，最终极的这个仇人。
So when we find ourselves in a situation of conflict with another person, then we need to appreciate that in actual fact, our real opponent is not the other person, it is the anger in their mind, and ultimately it is that which is our opponent and not the person.
所以这个时候我们要消灭的，要消灭的不是这个人，而是这个人的内心当中的愤怒。
And in this moment, what we need to realize is that that which we need to eliminate or get rid of is not the person, but rather the anger in their mind.
如果我们把这个人的内心当中的愤怒给消灭了，给消灭了以后呢，这个人还会对我不好吗？我们还会有矛盾吗？永远都不会的。有可能我们可以成为非常好的朋友。
If it's possible for us to eliminate the anger in the other person's mind, then will it be the case that they will still be our enemy or our opponent? No, it won't. If we are able to successfully eliminate their anger, then it is entirely possible that we even might become good friends.
好，现在我们知道了我们该消灭的东西是什么。
So now we are clear about what it is that we need to eliminate or get rid of.
什么是我们的真正的敌人？
And what is our real enemy or what is our real opponent?
好，那么对方的心里的愤怒是我们的真正的仇人、敌人。那么这个愤怒，我们用什么样的方法才能够消灭？
So if our real enemy is the anger inside the other person's mind, then what method can we use to eliminate it?
因为这个人，因为各种各样的原因，他伤害了我们，他对我们，说了不利的话，做了很多不利的事情，那么我们这个时候反而，对他不好，这样子的话，那么我们就不但是不能消灭他的内心当中的愤怒，而且他的愤怒就让他更加的这个发展。
So if we find that due to all kinds of reasons somebody has caused us harm, they've not treated us well, whether through their speech or through their actions, if we in response treat them badly, then we will discover that not only are we unable to eliminate the anger or the affliction in their own mind, but rather that we cause it to increase.
那么我们这个时候，对别人，第一个理解，不仅仅是理解，而且我们这个时候对他好，爱他，慈悲他，这样子的时候呢，他的这个对方的内心当中的愤怒啊，一下子这个怒火一下子会熄灭。
What we can discover or will discover is that if in this moment we are able to exercise empathy and understanding for the other person, to treat them with love and compassion, then our enemy's anger will immediately begin to dissipate.
然后我们拥有了一个这样子的慈悲心，爱心来，消灭了他的愤怒，他的愤怒，这样子以后呢，实际上我们就消灭了我们的敌人。
And when we find ourselves being able to eliminate their anger through compassion, then we will discover ourselves eliminating our enemy.
所以从大乘佛教的角度讲，消灭敌人，消灭敌人的最好的方法，最好的方法不是这个世界上的任何一个武器，而是爱和慈悲心。
So from the perspective of the Mahayana teachings, the best means or method of destroying one's enemy is not any kind of weapon, but rather the means of love and compassion.
它超过所有的世界上最先进的、最厉害的武器。
And in fact, these particular means, these particular methods transcend by far the most advanced weapons that exist.
如果我们所有人的心里就有这样子的慈悲心，有这种爱，那么全世界啊，杀伤力最严重、最大的这些所有的武器啊，一下子就会失效，啊，没地方用，一下子就会失效的。
If every single person in the world in their minds had these things, love and compassion, then in one instant, all of the weapons that do exist would become immediately obsolete. We'd have no use for them whatsoever.
所以大乘佛教通过他的观察所得到的结论是消灭敌人的最最最好的武器就是爱。
So in Mahayana Buddhism, through the observation of Mahayana Buddhism, the conclusion that is derived is that the best means or method for destroying one's enemy is love and compassion.
这个很难做到啊，但是呢，如果我们逐步的去这个训练，那么每一个人也可以做得到。
This is very difficult to do. However, if we are able to train in it gradually, step by step, then it is something that everyone is able to implement.
好，这是我们怎么样啊解决愤怒的这个方法当中其中一个方法。我们今天就讲到这里啊，其他的方法我们可以明天啊给大家继续介绍。
So that is tonight what I've addressed is one particular method or approach that we can take to dealing with or eliminating anger. And tomorrow's teaching, I am going to address further methods.
好，今天我们的课讲完了，我们最后大家做一个回向。
So that is the end of the teaching tonight, and we are just going to conclude with a dedication of merit.
回向的意思呢，我们今天大家来听课讲课，那么这个功德分享给天下所有的生命啊，那这叫做回向。
So when we talk about dedicating merit, what this means is tonight through having come and listened to this teaching, we have generated a great deal of merit, and so we end the teaching by sharing that merit with all beings.
然后我们发自内心的希望天下所有的众生以我们的这个功德能够健康长寿啊，幸福快乐，最终啊，大家都能够成佛，能够解脱啊，这样子的心愿叫做法心。
And we dedicate the merit to other beings with the very strong hope and aspiration that by the strength of our merit, they may enjoy good health, long life, happiness, and ultimately achieve Buddhahood and liberation.
Sonam de ye tamsu zumbanya doni ni be danam banjis. Jiganan ji valon tumbai. Tibin zolin doa dorar sho. Oma ahom banzerngur bamas de hong. Oma ahom banzerngur.
谢谢大家，大家晚安。